Welcome to Profile Traders. This is Reza and you're listening to my analysis for Thursday, January 29th. So yesterday was the Federal Reserve meeting and the statement that came out of the meeting is that they are upbeat on the economy and that they will also be patient with raising rates. Now, I admit that I'm a dumb man with a very limited capacity to understand things. But I have a question for you, Madam Chairman. Madam, for 6 years, the Federal Reserve has spent trillions of dollars, and for 6 years, it has done QE every single day, creating one of the nastiest looking bubble chart that is the stock market. And for 6 years, while the value of the dollar was crashing and crushing, and the wealth of every single dollar owner was getting totally depleted and the currency devaluated, you kept on doing QE after QE after QE, helping the destruction of the dollar for years. Now what I don't understand, madam, is that now that the curve has completely reversed itself and every other country out there is devaluating its currency against ours, therefore killing our export advantages. Now, at this point, where the dollar is so strong that even the big crooks, S&P 500 companies, are starting to complain that it's completely hurting their exports. Now, madam, the Federal Reserve is completely obsessed with raising rates. Madam, may I ask you if that raising rates, is it to bankrupt this society of consumer that you have built on a house of cards based on 0% interest, that you will bankrupt by raising rates on them because their payments on their house of cards 0% financing will go to the roof and nobody will pay and it will be another catastrophic debacle like we saw you manage during the real estate bubble markets? Or is it to bankrupt the pimp with his $17 trillion of debt and growing a trillion and a half on a yearly basis? That if you raise rates on them or him, he will no longer be able to service that debt. So, madam, which one is it? Do you truly believe that we are all idiots? So stop this BS with your raising rates. Not you, not your grand-grandchildren will be raising rates. Any rate hikes on the United States means bankruptcy with the level of debt that we have. Of course, the little guy Reza knows, but you, the big madam, the chairman, doesn't, obviously. So, that put aside, let's look at what's going on in here. Nothing is going on. Every single time that the market reaches that zone that I gave you on January 2 in my recap, the blue lines are still on that chart, you can go check, the buyer shows up. So we are now in a very nasty trading range that extends itself from this top to this low here. Obviously, the lows are more aggressively defended, as you can see by these candle rejections to the upside, leaving behind these little tiny bars. But on the top up there, except the fact that it's a whatever you want to call it, a tweezer top or a double top, say all the same stuff. Besides that, there is no rejection of any sort. Therefore, that top is very susceptible to be popped up. Also, look at how much they sold in these 3 days. The sell volume came as low as we did here, but look how far up price stayed. That's a very, very bullish divergence. With that said, meaning that the top is very vulnerable to a break on the upside, I must also tell you this, that since now everybody is looking at this, of course not everybody has the knowledge, but if you have the knowledge and understand what is going on, everybody with understanding would expect this thing to go up. And if it doesn't, up on a break below the 1965 or whatever this low is, you should expect then a cataclysmic drop. And as it will go up, then we are targeting the touch of this uptrend resistance line up there somewhere around probably 2130-ish. So that's the situation with ES. In terms of as of right now, real support is at 2001, 2000 even. This whole range and this whole area here is very shaky looking. It could easily be retraced during the overnight. But as long as now we remain above 2000, we are again back to be bullish, and it definitely could go up towards that POC up there, one at 2024-ish, and then another one at 2053. As for crude, nothing at all to report except sideways chop, undecisiveness, a little bit of lack of interest, people going out of business, some coming in buying for the longer term, some buying for business need, some speculating. It's pretty much, I would say, a chop market. The same thing that I would tell you all the time that I repeat now here, moves are fast, moves are two-sided, you can't get married to neither side. If the market pays you a nice lump sum on a nice run, you take the money, you get on your knees, you kiss the ground, and you thank for it. That's all you can do with this market as of right now. But in the very short term, obviously now the main support becomes 43.5. If we do break to the downside, we shall see how much follow through it will generate. We are really, really getting dirt cheap. We are low 40s. What, we're going to go to the 20s? If that's the case, yes, expect a crash. But if you don't believe that it's realistic and the drop is now getting a little bit too old, like the drop of that loser called the euro, then you would agree that breakdowns will be short-lived and bounces up will immediately show up as it did on today when we did try to break yesterday low. No follow-through at all and we came back up. So as long as we remain above 43.50, shoot for the two POCs up there, 45.10 and then 46 up there. As for gold, I clearly warn you, 1300 was going to be a problem and we should not at all be surprised to see a drop on a profit taking after a 100 plus point rally. So has anything turned super duper bearish here? Not really. I mean, This is an asset that was under tremendous pressure for a long, long year. And there is a lot of people that are still having the taste of the blood from their beating in their mouth. And they are shy. So if there is $100 profit in a run, there will be a lot of people taking it. But it doesn't mean that it has spoiled anything. It's just a profit taking. Now, the main level of support will come in exactly at 1250, which is a main area of support. As long as we remain above 1250, we should further back up. In order to break to the upside, we need to clear 1260. Therefore, you can bracket this market now between 1250 for a breakdown and 1260 for a breakup. On a 60 breakup, we should go towards 1270. On the 1250 breakdown, we should go towards 1242 to 1240. So again, thank you for listening. This was Reza with ProfileTraders.com.